Hello, everyone. I am Pomone, also known as Minecraft Warrior 22. I prefer Pomone. Right. Today I'm going to be starting a single-player Let's Play. One of a few. Right, let's just dive into it. Let's see what I have on. Nope. Go. Let's start off. And I'm currently recording this on August 14th, 2014. For some people in the US, it would be the second day of school. One more year, then I get to go to college.
Ooh. Wow. Loading. Oh, 14W32D. Hello. Alright, let's start off by finding a, well, nice place to live. The seed generation hasn't changed much, and so I know a couple villages around, but I don't think I'll be going that route this time. So, you know, the basics, the boring stuff. Getting wood, hidey hole, sheep, etc. AP courses. College classes in high school. They were a little interesting. Basically, I planned for 3 this year, but I only have 2. And last year, on the AP test, I got a 5 on it. For those of you that don't understand a word what I'm saying. Getting a 3 or higher means that you passed and you get $100 cash after doing good on your test. And the maximum score is 5. And I was the only one that year in any of the tests to get a 5. And so, first day of school, all the teachers say, "I saw what you got on your AP score. You did a good job." And I'm like, "Okay, how do you even see that? Is that right? It's our job to know." And I don't know. It's a little weird. But the AP test I had was AP Environmental Science. And one interesting thing is, I've got quite the setup right now. Any what noise I get rid of from the post-editing, with the help of Audacity, you know, the cheapest way effectively of getting rid of background noise, etc. And I don't have commands to do that, right. At least I hope you can hear the music. Okay, now that we're back through that speed up, let's start, I guess. Alright, where should we start digging in? Oh. I better bring that on mutton, because I don't want to be starving now, don't I? That didn't sound right. Someone who's taking AP English Literature, they should be a little bit better with their linguistic skills. Oh well, would expect that. English is my second language, and I'm learning Spanish along with French. It gets confusing because salud, good health, in Espanol, and then you have salud hello, and jingle bells. You started playing. Not that bit on there. Oh, bunnies! Bunny. Fork hole. I'm gonna dig this down to, hopefully, as low as I can, possibly bedrock. Fast forward it. See you in a month. These achievements are bothering me. Tokyo. Look up to 4, 6. There we go. Okay. Chickadee. That's where there were more chickens. Oh well. And it's getting dark. That is the first night. Feels like it went by a little quick. But then again, I did fiddle around with the settings. Okay, battery on the mice. The mouse. So, weird. Tree cutting! Woo! Let's go chop down trees. Oh, I was gonna fast forward it, but I think you need to hear this. I'm listening to a Doctor Who song, Doomsday. Season 2, episode 13. It's called Doomsday, you know where. Well, no spoilers, but there's a very sad song in there, which is just incredibly beautiful sounding. How I happened to come across it is a little interesting, and I came across it before I even started watching Doctor Who. Not that the song made me start watching Doctor Who, and I eventually got enough nerve to finally see what everyone's talking about. I started watching it in the first part of season 6. First part of, oh, we're also hosting a Doctor Who party for Series 8 premiere. next weekend. And I hope it is gonna be amazing. Although we still need to find out the details, like whose house, what time, etc. You know, details. On European time, so that makes it work. Well, here it is. 8 o'clock in the morning, around the time my nephew wakes up. I don't know this yet. So, wake up, stay up for, I don't know, 13 hours before we go, and then when we do go, I film this amazing underpass. It's not an underpass, it's 4 underpasses, one over the other. If you've been to the Cincinnati airport, it's one of the things to look out for. Hopefully, I can, actually, I have that, no, I deleted it after I rage quitted. Had footage of that, at least, but, I believe it in my radius. So once we got to the airport, traveling my suspenders, the passport photo had me in suspenders as well, which was a little funny, because the TSA person that checks passports before security, just pointed out, and I'm like, oh yeah, that's right, it's a shame I'm not wearing those exact suspenders, but, I do have them with me in the bag. Alright, through security, we got on the, underground transport train to terminal Concourse B, gate 5, Delta flight 229 to Charles de Gaulle, Paris. Yeah. Oh, I also have a sort of photographic memory, but that doesn't help on tests, because you have to learn to parse it all out. So the flight there was fine. Paris, we had 4 hours in the morning in Paris. We made silly faces. I have pictures of those, but I'm not willing to show my face. So, 4 hours in Paris, then we got on our flight to Sofia. I and my father then went to see our cousins in Levski. A week there, so much footage. Basically, it rained a lot. We did get to go to the pool once. Like a community pool. That's what it is. It's sort of a town, not a city. It's a town, but not a village. Oh yeah, there's villages, but not like NPC villages, like Italian villages, except not on mountains and with gypsies. Yeah, with gypsies. Around Levski, there's a lot of Brits and Americans who are retired and just live there because it's cheaper enough. And when they're looking for real estate, they can't buy it because they're not born in Bulgaria. They don't have citizenship and probably never will be able to get it because Bulgaria is, a challenge to them, let's put it, and leave it at that. But, yeah, it makes for nice conversations, and I believe my aunt got me addicted to tea. Every morning, I'd go to the cafe where she works and made me a cup of tea and pancakes. Bulgarian pancakes. You have not eaten a pancake until you've had Bulgarian pancakes. It's a bit like... Jeez, you have something sort of like it. You have, like, this thinner pancake, and you put, like Nutella and bananas on it. They have that in London, I believe. And that's the closest thing it is, but you can put so much more. You can make them salty, you can make them sweet, and I'm not going to continue talking about that. So, from last game, I went back to Sofia in a Volkswagen Caddy that runs on methane, and I'm like, why doesn't America have, like, cars that run on methane? I mean, and then my brother-in-law, my sister's husband, said, well, you know, America, they start wars over petrol. Except it's not petrol, it's naphtha. There. And, yeah, that's completely true. Here we have electric cars, but the electricity here is still pretty ridiculously stupid. Like, it's not... Right, in the city where I live, we have a gigantic coal power plant. Thankfully, I don't live in the city, I live in a subdivision. But if I were to go downtown, the air is so much dirtier because of that coal power plant. Right, we don't have any sort of renewable energy around here. I mean, they tried doing fracking, thankfully they did not. But, in Kentucky, I mean, you got coal in both eastern and western parts of it, and here, they just use it. So, thankfully, this environmental science class I took last year did not take place in eastern or western Kentucky. Oh, do you all like the logo up there? Basically, it's something I designed in art class my freshman year, so 2 years ago. And I've been developing it since, and I've used it as a flag for a Kerbal Space Program. Because it looks cool. I mean, I have an even more interesting one that I don't feel like putting on screen right now. I can do it live, because I'm using an open broadcasting system. Ooh, day two. Still nice. What was that? Last year, right. We drove back to Sofia to pick up my mom, because we take sort of shifts. Like, we come in a week earlier to get to see the cousins, because my mom does not want to see her sister-in-law, for reasons. Nor her own mother-in-law. But, that's not all. And, she comes a week later. That way we always have work to do this year in the apartment that we own. We renovated a bedroom. We threw out the wardrobe. When I say wardrobe, I mean a closet that lines a 3-meter hole. And we got rid of the bed, and, what's the thing where women keep their makeup and there's a mirror behind it. We got rid of that as well. We basically bought a new bed completely. The living room was the year before that was the sister's wedding, and their bedroom, all the stuff to be renovated, is the kids' room, where I sleep. Right, so after we got the bed done, 2 days in, I, of course, sleep in the kitchen the first night, since they had to clean out the wardrobe. We all went to the kids' room, so I couldn't sleep there, and basically, I slept in the kitchen, my mom and dad slept in the couch on the living room for 2 days until the bed came. The closet came the next week, so I still slept in the kitchen. And afterwards, we finally cleared the kids' room, and I was able to sleep there. Let's see. Right. There's an Armenian holiday, Vatavar. Basically, it's something to do with water, I'm not entirely sure. Ooh, floaty island. Ooh, it is a floaty island. This is amazing. Alright. I don't know how to talk. Ooh, mushrooms. Alright, yo. And there's pictures of me doing that, and my nephew who was adorable when he basically a challenge to balance a cup of water on a ruler, walking like 4 or 5 meters, 12 feet, 7 yards, something like that. Not 12 feet, yeah, a bit more, 12 yards. Not 12 yards, darn it. 4 or 5 meters. And, he just happened to just fill it with his... No one got it on camera. Right, there were pictures, but not of the moment, and I wasn't recording. It's a shame I missed out on that opportunity. But after that, I believe my dad had to go back in Sofia, so I'm with my mom and cousins. Oh, I really don't want to go to the sad part of the story of what happened this summer. Well, of course, all of you probably know what happened to Robin Williams on the 12th, 2 days ago. Words. No me gusta. Right. So, I drove with my dad. So I didn't drive. We had a chauffeur who is the father of my mother's godchild. But at the time, my dad was not the godfather. That's funny to say. Alright, godfather. Right, you get to sleep again. And, on the way back, because the flight is in 7 in the morning, 7:20 in the morning, we have to be there by 5:20 to check in, and, I have to be there at 5, some 5:20, check in, right, we left at 12, we got there at 4 something in the morning, except I woke up at 9, and the chauffeur probably woke up a little later, and so we didn't get much sleep. And on the drive back, because there's like a 50-something age gap, we almost bumped someone in front of us. We were driving between two lanes, and right, the driver almost fell asleep, and I'm like, "Kaspa!" And that got his attention. We found the nearest rest stop. We missed the entrance, and we walked back. We came back through the exit. Bulgarian highways allow for that. It's not breaking law if you do that. All right, the reason why I'm tearing down these trees is so I can tear down this hill and make a tree farm, or make a tunnel through it and build a tree farm here. So I, and on the way back, I managed to, alright, and on the way back from Sofia, OBS just stopped for some reason, not really sure. Right, and I'm streaming, damn it, I'm streaming, not recording. Oh well. Right, the university that I completely missed because I was filming forwards, and then on the way back I got it. And for the filming, but in the end I lost it. Oh yeah. This year, I got 2 trench coats from my dad. I got 4 shirts from my dad, which he never wore after Balkan Airlines was sold to a Jewish person. Not that there's anything wrong with that, it's just that one person bought a privately owned company and then sold off the planes for bits. Reminds me of an episode of Suits. The most recent one, season 4, I believe it was. Season 4, episode 4. Yeah. Some of that recent one. And, yeah, 2 trench coats, 4 shirts, 2 short sleeve, 2 long sleeve, perfect fit, 43 by 173 centimeters, 43 neck size, etc. They are an amazing fit, and I like them so much. The other thing is, what was it? Oh yes, 2 trench coats, and I got a nice Bulgarian wool blanket for the winter. Not that there's much of a winter here, but I like it. Brain fart. Sorry, where was I? Oh yes, and a nice wool blanket. It's not wool exactly, because it doesn't feel like the wool blankets they have in America. Oh, also, on my way back, I brought a 3-liter bottle of water. Through an airport, of course, it was empty, and I said, oh, I just have a canister of oxygen just in case, you know, joking around me. The APU on the flight. There's a bunch of stuff. Now I'm just accidentally leaving out memory. But, the last week of my stay in Burgas, I got on the ferry boat on the pier Mostica. Mosta, in case you understand Bulgarian. But, yeah. And I got to the island, bathed a bit, island. That was extremely fun. The island, I had some potato wedges, monster style. And, those were good. Ice cream, yogurt, oh, figs. Americans know nothing about figs. Figs are the best thing on the world. Oh yeah, my father-in-law, my brother-in-law's father, is an amazing cook, and so we shared recipes and cooking, right? Also, we went to their, not resort, there's basically buildings along the beach that are apartments, except there's like 16 rooms, just bedrooms and bathroom in one building. It's right along the shore. It's not a resort, it's more like a, oh god, what's it called? Do you know when you look up places to stay and they have these houses that you can go in? Not rent the house, like stay in the house for the weekend or whatever time you plan. And talk with the owner. I'm not sure what those are called. I'm gonna look it up. But yeah, that's what it was. Oh god, they had some amazing grill works. So, basically you have pork. Pork, whatever, pork, ribs, etc., what have you, bacon, olive oil, salt, lemon juice, marinade for 2 weeks, and you put it on the grill, and you don't touch it until the outside starts to cook. Instead of the rosy pink, it turns into this palish white. And you turn it over and add rosemary, it is delicious. Those of you that don't understand anything about cooking, I apologize. It's good pork. Mm. 3 days to chop down forest. Oh, the other thing, the nearest desert and the nearest greatwood forest and pine forest, the big pine, are so far away, especially if you use large biomes. But even then, this is a large, long way away. Oh, right, I know that because I used amidst, you know, the thing that shows you the chunks and stuff. But I've also played this map several times. This is third, fourth time playing it, I believe. I did a lot of stuff over summer. I would have loved to filmed it, and if I had gotten that footage, I wouldn't mind putting my face up on YouTube. But my face is already on YouTube from WorldFest, an event we have here in Kentucky. Oh god, someone was filming at the event, and I was walking straight towards the guy with the camera, and just passed by them, and then I was just looking up clips from that year's WorldFest, and there couldn't have been a clearer picture of me. Jeez. But, oh yeah, European soirees, those are nice. I love that. I always go. Oh yeah, 16 went by, and I don't plan on getting a driver's license. Oh yes, towards the end, right. My sister has a dog named Bella. She had 5 children. She bit one of their necks, and it died early on. 2 of them got sold. 1 got given to my brother after my sister's father. I have a different father than my sister. We both share the same mother as well as my brother. I also have another sister from my father, but that isn't. We just recently knew of her existence this summer. But otherwise, yes. Bella has children. The ones that stay in the family are Hera, and Spot. Spot has their English bulldogs, and the mother's white. She's just pure white. Oh, so white. Sorry. She has like 2 little spots on her lower region of the ear butt, basically. Spot has a huge brown spot in the same place as mother does, and Hera is so far just like her mother, but she's still a baby and has her baby fur, and it's my soft coat. And basically Hera is not disobedient, but crazy. Her mother, she just sucks on this like little stuffed animal, her little stuffed teddy bear, which is a little tiny, like a little baby sucking on a bib. But none of her children have that trait, and I hope I can find a picture of Bella and put it in the video. Hopefully now. Right. I really hope you saw a picture of her because the story gets sad. So we got rid of Hera. We moved her because my dad didn't want the chairs, the doors, and wooden frames. Everything got chewed up. The old bedroom got chewed up, that's why we replaced it. Reason number 2. And basically, we just had Bella, and she was, just the heaven on earth when you're talking about dogs. Oh, my nephew is just like 6 months older than her. Right? At my sister's wedding, she had the rings on her back, and I was, holding a leash. It was adorable. Weddings, you know. I was chubbier then. Still, I am at this time. Right, and she just got tired. You know, bulldogs, they sort of grunt like pigs. Not grunt, like snore almost, but I'm not sure what it's called in English. But yeah, she did that because she's a little fat and it's hot in the summer there. It was anywhere between 27 and 30 something degrees Celsius. I'm not translating in Fahrenheit because I hate that imperial system. There's more trees up there. I'll get them later. But, yeah. And, when we were going to Sofia to the airport, we had 2 days in Sofia left over before our flight, because my nephew needed to get vaccines, and, we were gonna go back as well. And so, instead of leaving my brother Hike with 2 untamable dogs, we decided to just have the quiet one, Bella, with him, and then Spot, and we take care of Sophia. Right? Spot has some problem with his eyes. There's this orange, rosy thing in his eye that just puffs up and it almost curtains his eye. It's not cataracts. It's something that they get rid of. They operate on bulldogs when they're little. So he's big. And Bella's had breathing issues. Right? So we leave her there and go to Sophia with Hera. I forgot what it was. She's named after some Greek goddess. I don't remember. No, no, they wanted to name her. Because... whatever. Right. So we go to Sophia. First day, we go to sleep. Exhausted. Second day, we go take a walk around Sophia, and that's the first time I've ever taken a walk around the capital. All my 12 years of traveling to Bulgaria every summer. Oh, this is the 13th year, by the way, I'm back. So... that's nice. Right. Put everything up, didn't I? And so we have Hera, and dog food, etc. Right, we have planes, etc. We woke up at 4 in the morning, got up to go to the airport, etc. You know, usual stuff. Got on the plane, saw the plane. Well, oh god, my thighs were chafed because I decided to wear these stupid shorts. Like these fake material shorts. And, I just realized that's a little bit too much information. But sorry. And so, we went back to America, right? And then, the next morning, my mom slept on the couch for some reason in the living room. I went to bed early, around, 4 p.m., and woke up at 5, so I'm already in the school schedule now. Well, school, it's like the second day of school, and it's crazy. I was thinking about being vegetarian this month, but you know, it's a little late for that, I guess. So, what was I? Right. And, right, my mom had to get something from the bedroom, etc. And she came back and she was in tears. And huffing and puffing. And it turns out that 4 p.m. our time, Bella died of pneumonia. The whole week that we were there, back in Burgess with her, we noticed she had breathing problems, and we just thought it was hot, and just so much, right? And pneumonia is when you have water in your lungs. It's an easy problem to fix. They just drain your lungs and you take medication. It's a simple fix, but apparently bulldogs just have that as... that should be in their life insurance, basically, but they don't have life insurance, I don't think. So she died of pneumonia the time I went to bed. And not to mention, I had a nightmare. And also, my mom had a nightmare that night. And, which is strange, we love the little thing. Not that we get to see her much. We only see her for a month, a year. I see her that much. My parents see her once. And, if we'd left Hera with Ike and Hera with Spot, and taken Bella with us, and Sophia to the capital, we would have been able to help her. But, the past is the past. At least her daughter looks just like her. Hopefully we can keep her the same way. Oh god. When my mom went to work the next day, there was a picture of her grandson, my nephew, and Bella on her desk, and that photo just brought it home. And 2 days later, I find out that Robin Williams dies. Well, passed away. And just kept laying on, and then I have medical investigations class where we're going to be talking about people with cancer. And this year, it's just going to be a pile up of emotions. That's one thing that's going to be sure for this whole entire year. 13 apples? That's nice. Actually, I'm going to not eat the apples because it's dark. Alright, thankfully, my ninth grade year, I was introduced to Buddhism. Not Buddhism in general, in its belief system, but more of the spiritual side of it, as in chakras, meditation, astral travel, lucid dreaming, not exactly Buddhism. And... I was able to get over it in 3 days before school starts. And I was fine, okay, Still talking about it, bring up the memories, think about what I could have done. It brings it home even further. And I don't really get over it yet. And now I know why my mom never wanted me to have pets. She had a cat, Hercules, the translation, Hercules. And the whole family, my brother, my sister's parents, and my dad, were just in extreme grief when Hercules died. It had to do with the cat food, something with his colon. But I was still a baby, one year old, and I couldn't remember much of that. Right, but aside from that dying, my grandpa, my last grandpa, died 41 days before I was born. And since then, there have been no deaths. No relatives, no pets, no nothing died. Except last year, my brother's dog died. And the son was like, oh, where's your dog? Because I didn't know, right? And he's like, he died, don't you remember? He's like, oh, I'm sorry. And I'm like, who's Scott? But, yeah. I still have both my grandmas. My nephew, he has three uncles, three grandpas, two grandmas, dogs, and, oh god, at my sister's wedding there were 200 people. First and second cousins along with friends of the family. Big wedding. We played some French ballroom dance, it was fun. Where was I? Oh yes, no, I got it again. I forgot where I was going with that. Oh yeah, I haven't experienced the trauma of a death of a close one. Right, my grandma's friend who was married to her brother died of cancer, but her brother was, well, died before her sister-in-law. But they weren't really close to me, and I didn't feel any grief or trauma from that. And to make it to 16 this far without any deaths is a miracle. And I'm just grateful that I haven't experienced this when I was littler, like 7 or 12. Because that would have just been a terrible experience. Now to go on to the next point. I lucid dream almost every night. And so much so that I've basically given up on lucid dreaming. So basically I don't no longer have lucid dreams. I basically have vivid dreams, where I can recall every exact moment of every single moment in the dream. That lasts 15 minutes. Let's say I've been sleeping all night, right? I wake up, see the time, and then I go back to sleep. Dream. Wake up, see the time, 15 minutes later. And so I've written some of these down, publicated them on Fiction Press, because they're not really fan fiction, so I can't put on fanfiction.net. But, yeah, vivid dreams. It's like living in a completely different world. Oh, you probably want to know what it is, right? You know when you come up with thoughts like, oh, I wonder what it would be like if I were a YouTuber, or only I was in the Doctor Who universe, and there was Nadine and all these things, and Sarah Jane, and oh, poor this was later. Right, more deaths. Perfect. But yeah, so basically I entertain the thought. I parole in the universe that I live out daily. Basically, when I go to sleep, I start living in that world. When I wake up, well, I don't necessarily go to sleep in that one and wake up here, because that reminds me of a movie before Inception that was meh. I forgot what it was called. But the final freezer had been cut down. And now I can't keep stalling for time for these first few episodes. Now we're gonna go mining. The other thing about mining is I go extreme all-out mining. I systematically explore, hug the left wall, place torches on the left side. And I hate ravines because they always open up so many freaking cases. And I don't leave, I don't go back up until my inventory is filled to the brim. After refining, crafting everything in the blocks, if I'm not done exploring that cave, I don't leave. Which is something I really don't like. But that's like, I don't even have OCD. Just playing Minecraft brings this out in me. Alright, all the trees have been cut down. Now, the question now is, do I make a base above ground? Or a base underground? Yeah. Holy crap, that's a lot of stacks of, trees. A little cobble left, I need to bring that, right. Down we go, mining. Right, fast forward. I'm gonna stop talking about my experiences. Fast forward till I can get a little area set up for branch mining. If I don't encounter a cave, I'm probably gonna make an x-ray with the fences and just... Where is that? There it is. Jeez, right. Is that at your head? Head 12, so that's as deep as we're gonna go. Right. So we're gonna get the other space here. There we go. Aha! So is that y equals 16, 15, 15, 15, I'll go here. Let's do this one here instead. Alright, so this is going to be the mine. And I think I'm going to call it here for an episode. Radio then, I will see you all next episode. Thanks for watching. Goodbye, I've been Pamon. See y'all next time.